Hello, my name is Shawn Simpson. I'm the product manager for Fortify WebInspect and ScanCentral DAST. Today, I'd like to talk about our new FAST proxy that we have in ScanCentral DAST 21.1. This is a lightweight proxy that can be used for capturing traffic from functional tests, APIs, manual testing, or even a phone. And we'll take that traffic and perform an audit, or you can also perform an additional crawl-in audit where we'll capture new traffic maybe not found in the original test. First, we need to set up a few things in ScanCentral DAST and SSC. First, in ScanCentral DAST, we'll need to set up a settings configuration. To do this, we'll select New Scan, where we'll pick our application and version. We'll do a standard scan, crawl and audit against zero. We won't do any site authentication for this demo, but we will need to add an allowed host. The reason for that is we don't automatically pick up an allowed host from a proxy capture. Then we get to our summary page. Here we'll need to give it a name. In this case, it'll be Zero Fast Demo. And once we have that name, we can hit Save. And we'll be given a settings identifier. This is this one here. This is what we're going to use for the CI/CD token when configuring the FAST proxy. And if we ever forget the name of that token, we can always come to our settings list where we can find it listed under CI/CD identifiers. Next, in SSC, we need to create what's called a CI token. This is what allows us to authenticate against the API. We do need a CI token. We can give it an expiration date, and we can say this is for FAST proxy use. This will be usable for 1 year. Once it's saved, we're given the token here. And this needs to be noted down because once we leave this screen, it will not be available again. So we'll copy it. Now that we have both of our tokens configured, we're ready to set up the proxy. By default, it is located in Program Files, Microfocus WIRC Server as fast.exe. First, we need to select the port that the FAST proxy will be listening on, say dash P. We'll then, with a dash U option, select the location of the ScanCentral DAST, not the SSC API. We then need to configure the dash CI token. This is the one we configured in SSC under token management. And finally, we set our CI/CD token. This is the token we configured when we set up our settings configuration in ScanCentral DAST. We can hit enter. In a moment, we will be told our proxy is listening on port 8087. Already got a browser set up there, and we can see it is sending traffic to the proxy. We'll just send a couple quick sessions to that. We can see all the traffic that we capture. To stop the proxy, we need another command prompt, because our other one is already consumed with the proxy listening. We then run FAST, we give it the port we're listening on, we select dash S. We look in our other window, we can see this has stopped the proxy, it has captured all of our traffic, and it has sent it up to ScanCentral DAST for queuing a scan. Now we can go back to ScanCentral DAST. Look in our scans list, and we see we have our new scan is running and will be available to review the results soon. Thank you for joining me in this tutorial today. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. Again, thank you. Have a great day.